Hello everyone. Today we are going to take lecture 14 on the different type of a transducer. So in the first one I am going to discuss about the resistive transducers, where again we will be discussing about the categorizing into three types there. Okay. Now the first, what do you mean by resistive transducer? Usually resistive transducers are one whose resistance changes due to change in some physical phenomena. Okay, this physical phenomena may be change in the length of the conductor, or it might be some temperature increase in the resistance might change the length of the conductors or any materials like that. It can be used. That can be used as a measure of displacement. Usually, strain gauges works on the principle that the resistance of a conductor or a semiconductor changes when strained. This can be used for the measurement of displacement, force and pressure. Okay, when we use it like a displacement, it can be when you apply pressure, the distance or a variation in the place, that we call as the displacement there. Or the force, amount of the force applied or amount of pressure applied. So force and pressures are related to same other, but depends on the some factor quantities. Usually remember that resistance of the resistivity of the materials changes with the changes in temperature. This property can be used for the measurement of temperature. As I earlier told, that some physical phenomena. Here the physical phenomena might be the change in the temperature. What it affects? Change in the temperature, which automatically changes the length of the conductor. So when the change of the length of the conductor change, the resistivity of the materials also change. So they are interlinked with respect to each other. So here we will classify into three types. The first one is the potentiometer. This is the normal potentiometer what we will be using in our labs. Okay. So usually you can see here you have a sliding contact here. Okay, I think you might be used in your physical lab that where we use this kind of a sliding contact and a change in the resistance, or visually we use in a circuit lab, we call it as a pot. Depends on the resistance, 1 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm pots it will be there. How it work? And you can see here. Here, usually we have a 2 or 3 terminals there. So I am just taking a consideration of my 2 terminals. You can see here one and another, the positive and the negative might be. Okay, usually we don't have any kind of a terminals for this one, but when you are giving a supply, it might be considered as a positive and this might be a negative. So that time what it will be, this will be the higher potential, this part of the resistance will be higher potential, this part will be the lower potential. So what will happen, there will be a pointer or it will be a sliding contact we say. What we are doing, a slider will be usually used in the middle here. Always it should be middle so that it can be stable between high and the low in medium level. If you change it like in that from this direction, so that time you remember one thing, that is the always remember V is equals to I into R. So we know R here. You know V here, but we need to know current. So what it will have, so as voltage is increased, resistance also should increase. So when this sliding contact is moved to this here, the resistance is increased. So as I said, higher potential. When here it is decreasing here, it's a lower potential. So like that, okay, like that we'll be working here. So this is we call as a translatory, because it's a straight line or a linear type. Okay, straight devices here. Some of the devices are there. You can see here the resistance will be in like this way. They're curving, or we can say it's a rotational there. Here this is the sliding contact which will be moving like this way. This is terms in measured in terms of an angular displacement. Okay. This is in terms of the angular displacement. Next, this is another type which is called as a helix, where this is the stagnant here, and we asked to move this type of a helical circular cell. Okay, you can see here. So what it is doing, the pointer is here, fixed there. We try to twist it. So what will happen once, see here, once. So what will happen? So as this part is twisted, so that time this pointer is coming here. Like that it is. Okay. So this is, if you think as a sliding contact, you can see here. Now in the first here, it will be like this way. In the next one, another type. Okay. So first this is the point here. Next point, it will come below here. So it is like a twisted pair cables, like it will be coming. Okay. It will be in that way now. So this is how we do. So these are called as a heliports, because they have helical ports. The ports are in type of a helical shape, so they are called as a helical ports. These are usually inexpensive. They are simple to operate, just a sliding contact, and wherever you require, you can use it there. And they can usually use for the measurement of large amplitudes or displacement. So we can see it here. Their efficiency is very high, and they provide you to sufficient output to the allow control operation. Because whenever we need to give the less voltage, that you can control it by the sliding contact. We can see some of the oscillator circuit, we require this port to set to a one certain level. After that, it cannot give outputs. So it will be like a stability. So here we are using a pot as a stability factor in some of the circuits. I think this time you have it in your ADI lab. This time you don't have. You have it in your next time advanced communication analog circuit lab. It is in that you have a oscillator circuit to be designed. We are using a 1 MHz. So that time we need to stabilize using these pots. So these are usually to stabilize. So what it will give, controlling on this thing, we can give a efficient output. Next one is the disadvantages of this potentiometer. When we are using it for linear potentiometer, they required a large force to push for some of the big applications. Okay, one. Next one is the when the sliding contact is pushed through it, the friction occurs. So due to friction, lot of friction, there might be a damage, or there might be a wear out of some of the thing, or might be alienation, or might generate noise there. In the friction is there. So this is one. These two are the disadvantages. Now looking into the resistance pressure transistor. Here you can see the circuit here. These are the bellow types, where we can say it as a one kind of a the bellows, we say. Okay, these are like a part, strong part, and this will be lighter material that it will be folding here. That will merge during the when the pressure or strain is applied. Here you can see a resistance level which can be connected to the external bridge, and this is another kind of a, this both are the contacts. This is another kind. This is due to the this bellows resistance or the change in the resistance. This is due to the top at the below. These are the spring where we will be using as a where the when it is pressed there, it is the spring is compressed. And these are the usually the resistance contact which will be contacting another the bellow. This is the due to the here this movement, and this is due to the bellow movements. Okay, there are two types. So usually these are called as the electromechanical transducer, resistance transducer. This is another called as the resistance transducer, where this stress act directly on the resistance here. These are usually used for stress and displacement measurement, in which we'll be use it for the instrumentation pressure. Okay, this one is the in which a change of pressure, stress, position, and the displacement other can be applied to the variable. This can be taken as a both to the output. So usually the pressure inlets are used where we apply the pressure to it. See, when its pressure is applied here, the spring is made below and the bellow is gained full to top. Okay, this is another type. Okay, this is another type where the both the thing are below itself. This what happened is like a pressure here, the before, in the before circuit where the spring was in the below part and the bellow was in the above. Here they are using just a contacts there and the springs are connected to it. They are depending on this movement of the flat things. So this is usually connected to the bridge circuit, like what we use it for, might be any kind of a circuit depending on AC and DC circuits output expected, which shown capacitance, inductance, veins. So there are different things that will be connected. Here in this tool, there are two types here. In the before one, we had a bellow above and the spring below. Here, the pressure acting on the diaphragm here. The diaphragm is given from the inlet. And that on this pressure, the contact is pushed and the movement here or the resistance is causing the change in its length. And that is given to the circuits or the whatever the output we are expecting. And the, both the things are same. Another is type is the resistive position transducer. Here you can see a wiper here. Okay, it's a displacement type of a transducer. What you are doing, this is a conducting strip and the whatever the energy is there is being given here. So when this is pushed here, so the maximum all the contents, whatever the energy is here, is being transferred here. When it is moved back like here, and that time there will be no contact with it. So that time no energy is being transferred. So here, depending on the shaft, how much we required, how much the pressure is applied, so that much the contact will be there, and that the energy is being given here. It be, if for example, I consider here as the voltage has been given, and that has been passed here. It is like a pressure. You remember this for this purpose, electromagnetic induction, where the continuously passage of this whole core in field of it wires there. Here all the same principle, but what we are doing, whenever the pressure is applied, coming here, been contact with the conducting strip, pass. When there is no contact with this kind of a wires or the energy source, so that time it will be neutral, no energy has been passed. So here there's too little energy. Here again little higher energy, again here little higher energy, like that. The most space in the contact with the wiper, with the conduction strip and the source. So it's the maximum the pressure is and the maximum voltage has been passed on. Okay, this is the position where it will give. So this is the actual the function of the shaft, and usually you can calibrate in terms of a centimeters for a visual displacement. Here, that was the diagram where I will be using here a positional circuit diagram again. So this we know. Okay, this is circuit connected to the main resistance where I am dividing it into the R1 and R2. So depending on the contact, so this is here it comes, at that time it will be R1. Sorry, this is R2. Okay, you can see here. It is, if your position is here, so that time this is R2. If the position is here till here, so that time R2 is higher, R1 is lesser. So what it is doing, this wiper making a use of the resistance as to a requirement. The wiper might be positioned due to the some kind of a pressure or some kind of a displacement position. So what will happen? So what we require, that much amount of voltage has been transferred. If you want to transfer this much, or if you want to transfer this much. So depending on the output, we can decide. Okay, that we can give it by V0 is equals to VT. This is what the term we are giving. R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So this is, I am considering only as this circuit. Okay, I am considering only as this circuit. That where is the V0 with respect to R2. So this is on this basis I am going to show that output is directly proportional to the R2. If it was the wiper was in this direction, for example, if it was in like this way, so that time V0 here, if it was here, so then V0 was directly proportional to the R1. So that time V0 by VT is equals to R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So as per the output which is V required and to measure, that will be giving the output here. Okay, this is R2. This is R2, and what we required is from this calculations only. So this, if it length is little more, V is equals to IR. We know V is equals to IR. So voltage is increased, resistance is increased. So as resistance is increased here, V is also increased. So that's the logic. How, what we'll be using here. And usually the transistor is distributedly, this is uniformly distributed over the length of the travel of the wiper, and resistance is perfectly linear, we can assume. Okay, and usually the distance specification noise can be as low as 0.1 to 1%. That's your dependency. Okay, this all V0 is certain factor which is depending on VT. Understood. Thank you. And HS-Kelsey is the your reference textbook, and other two are the what will be, you can use it for additional reference. Okay, thank you.